The organic acid test, otherwise referred to as OAT, is a urine collection test that is going to give your practitioner some really helpful insights into multiple systems of your body, and really great information that's otherwise quite hard to get. So it's a really valuable test. Today we're going to talk through preparation and then how to perform the test on test day. You will have received your test kit. And so what is in the box? Well, firstly, about the box, please hold on to it. Don't throw it out. We do need it so that when we're posting, everything will go back into that box. You'll see there's a silver pouch and a little gel pack. Those two things need to go into your freezer today, even after this video, because they basically will act like an esky for transportation when it's time to post it. You'll see there's a clear collection container with a yellow lid, a small gauze strip. There's an instruction booklet, a requisition form, there's a see-through biohazard bag there, and an Australia Post Express Post bag. Preparation for this test takes 48 hours, so 2 days before you do the test, some careful considerations. Firstly, please avoid supplements and also non-essential medication. If you are taking medication that is important for your health, please keep doing so. Just communicate with your team what you're still taking in the preparation, and we might just need to make sure that there's no impact on test outcomes, or that the practitioner might need to consider that with interpretation. There are some foods to avoid. You'll see they're listed on the PDF that your coach will have shared with you. We also need a dehydrated sample, so the evening before you do the test, please minimize or stop intake of any liquids from around about 5 or 6 in the evening. And then, as we've already touched on, make sure that that gel sachet and the silver pouch are both pre-frozen before you do the test. Just a couple of important notes. Menstruation, so if you happen to be menstruating, you cannot do the test during menstruation. So that's an important thing to know. Also, if you've been taking any steroids, just have a chat with your practitioner or let your coach know, and they'll just clarify with the practitioner, just to make sure it's okay to go ahead. Now, on the day of the test, what you're going to do is get up in the morning and collect your first urine of the day. I also think it's quite valuable just to keep that little plastic container in your bathroom, so maybe just up on top of the loo. You don't want to get there sort of half waking up and realize your container's not there, especially if you've done 2 days of prep. So keep the container in your bathroom. It does ask for a 10 ml sample. We sort of say do about a third or a half of the container, no more than that, because of course it's liquid and it will expand when it freezes. But certainly you can do up to half of that little container. Once you've done it, turn it upside down and just test it. Make sure the lid's on properly, because what we definitely don't want is any of the liquid inside to leak out. You won't know that once it's frozen, so you need to test it before it's frozen. So basically, here's what we're going to do. Get up in the morning, collect the sample, make sure all of your paperwork's filled out, pop it into the freezer. This test must be sent by Australia Post Express Post on a Monday. Just be mindful of public holidays, and you must take it into your Australia Post shop. Don't drop it into one of the post boxes on the side of the street. So always go through your paperwork, make sure everything's being filled out, and then once you've posted it, please message your coach through Slack to let them know. After the test, just go back to eating as per normal. You can go back onto the supplements that you'd stopped taking, and once those test results come back, your coach will let you know through Slack. Please, please take the time to read the full instruction booklet that came with your test, because even though we share this video and we share a PDF, it's most important that you understand all of the parts for this test preparation, so that we can get the best out of it.